What's going on, everyone? Hey, I want to go ahead and share this while we're here live on some other groups. So I will give a chance for some people to jump on if you want to jump on. Let's see, when to engage with functional rehab while acute or low pain scale. This is something that just came up on a group training that we just did with a bunch of doctors in our implementation group, which is called SMART, which stands for success something something results training. We follow our success launch booklet, which, hold on. Hold on a second over here. That's not it. And here it is. So where we go through and follow our success launch manual inside of our Move Now University program. And anyway, something that came up, which I thought, actually Brandy thought would be a good idea to do a little Facebook Live and talk about this, is when do we... That's funny. Look at that. You can actually see me talk and text as I'm going live. That is crazy. Crazy, crazy, crazy. Not focused, but crazy, crazy, crazy. All right. Anyway, sorry. Just getting caught up in this technology here. It's kind of funny how that works. So the question is, when do we start? I'm not going to share this anywhere else right now. We'll have to do it after the fact. When do we start with functional movement with a patient? Do we start when they're acute, when they get out of the acute phase, after we've done a bunch of passive stuff to get them out of their acute scenario? And Brandy brought up a really great point. Brandy's our office manager and doctor support for Move Now University, one of our two doctor support. Other is Danny. And anyway, here's the problem. Is that patients get into a certain flow of mindset. And if you can start them off in a mindset where they understand that exercise is a vital role to their healing process, to their rehabilitation, that will up the chances of them actually sticking with it and getting the best results possible. So in our experience, what we found is that if we take someone who is hurting, and I'm not saying super, super acute. If someone's super acute, there's other stuff we're doing to try to get them out of that. We're not having them, you know, go work on mobility drills and that sort of thing in our functional movement area. But when someone's still like a 6 out of 10 on the pain scale, and we don't have a sharp cutoff, you know, it's really tailored to the individual. But let's say someone's a 6 out of 10 on a pain scale, they have low back pain. Well, we want to do a movement assessment. We know what movements are going to be probably faulty, and we're going to retest them once they get out of their semi-acute phase. But looking at other movement issues, remember in functional movement, one of the rules is you always work non-painful patterns. And if you can work non-painful patterns, even if the person has low back pain, you can find stuff to do that's non-painful. The really cool part about this is that the way it wires the nervous system and just how the body responds is you can start getting some pain relief in these other areas because certain muscles and tissues start to respond from something that's adjacent. So for example, someone has low back pain, but they have horrible hip mobility and they can do some hip mobility exercises without aggravating their low back starts to respond. Or if someone maybe just does some basic core engagement stuff and they learn how to breathe properly while they're having some, you know, chronic low back issues that are a 6 out of 10 pain, that's so maybe semi-acute chronic, their low back starts to respond. We teach people how to lift and how to move and how to pick things up. And like right from the get-go, even a acute low back person, we're teaching them how to hip hinge as soon as possible. So anyway, didn't introduce myself. For those of you who don't know who I am, I'm Dr. Todd Pickman from Move Now University. We also have a clinic called Gonstead Spine and Wellness out here in Meridian, Idaho. And we have close to 200 doctors. We're approaching that we help out with all of these systems all over the world as far as how to put functional rehab into their chiropractic practices. So we talk about these topics. We have a whole online curriculum that we built that goes through all these topics. And there's a couple things I wanted just to bring to your attention in closing on this topic, because I got to get going and go see patients myself, is we have an event coming up called Impact, which is a 4-day event. We got a bunch of people coming in to help teach with us, which is going to be amazing. One of them is a world famous Russian kettlebell instructor for a group called Strong First. And I bring that up because one of the things that we do with functional rehab is we do lots and lots of kettlebell work, and we teach the same basics that a kettlebell, like properly instructed kettlebell course would teach. which is hip hinging. Okay, so here, I'll throw this up here so you can see it. Okay, so these hands belong to a buddy of mine, Czar Horton. He's a Strong First Master Kettlebell instructor. So this guy right here, I'm showing the Strong First website. Well, if you go over to a link that we put, impact.movenowyou.com, you can check out this upcoming event, which is towards the end of February. So you click here to learn more, pops up, sends you a convenient email. So you have the link to get back into that second page with all the details on it. And you can look at all the stuff that's going on. So I encourage you to check that out. For one, it's open for non-members of Move Now University as well. If you just want to learn more about systems and functional rehab and how this all gets put together in a chiropractic clinic, I would invite you to come out and join us. All right. So now, second of all, if you haven't watched a demo of how our programs work and you're curious on how all this stuff looks, go to demo.movenowyou.com and you can jump inside and you'll basically watch me taking you through this whole portal here, which is our Move Now University portal. So a bunch of different sections and different lessons and all kinds of great stuff in here. It takes about 30 minutes to go through and walk through and show you this. I have a pre-recorded video you can check out. So anyway, moral of the story is we get people into moving and functional rehab and teaching them proper ways to get up, sit down, hip hinge, some postural considerations as soon as humanly possible, even if someone is somewhat acute. So don't think that you have to wait to start incorporating mobility, stability, pattern reinforcement, posture, proper basic movement patterns, breathing, hip hinge, core. You don't have to wait to do that until someone is like a 2 out of 10 on a pain scale. Okay. That's not what it's for. Fitness, you're probably going to wait until someone has little to no pain in fitness. We're not talking about fitness yet. We're talking about the transition of building a foundation so that these people can reinforce these healthy patterns with strength and power, AKA fitness. So anyway, Dr. Todd from Move Now. And I am signing out. I hope you found this helpful. I know it's quick and to the point and I talk fast, but I gotta go. So comment, check out the links that we posted up here, and we will see you soon.